Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Now it seems there are plenty of reviews of the GT730 here on YouTube, as well as the GTX750. Both of these cards are respectable in their own right, and both served a purpose upon release, with the GT730 being a suitable lower end offering, and the GTX750 being a great alternative to those who wanted to game at full HD, yet couldn't quite afford the 750 Ti. Sitting between the two though, well, it's this. The GT740. I thought to myself, surely I've made a video about this card. I mean, it's part of Nvidia's 700 series lineup, and I've probably covered most of those cards at least once. But the GT740? Never. Launching in May of 2014, it made its appearance after the ever-popular 750 Ti, and came in both a DDR3 and GDDR5 variant, with the latter being the better choice, of course. At $89 or £65, it was $30 cheaper than the 750 and featured 384 CUDA cores and an 80GB a second memory bandwidth. The sneaky folk over at Nvidia launched the DDR3 version at the same price with a significantly lower memory bandwidth. Does that sound familiar? With support for up to DirectX 12, the 740 should still be able to at least start and run the latest games, though with the GDDR5 card requiring one 6-pin connector, it certainly wasn't as convenient for lower-end systems as some of the latest budget GPUs out there. There's also not many reviews out there either, not compared to the 730 or 750 anyway. The card also had a competitor in the Radeon R7250X, a closely priced card that often outed it by 5-10 frames per second. So what about its performance? Well, in older AAA titles like Bioshock Infinite here, I saw 39fps at the high settings. On a card like this, I thought targeting a 30fps experience would be more realistic, and Bioshock hovers at around 30-40 most of the time, even in action-packed scenes like this one. Fallout 4, a title I've recently got back into after the announcement of Fallout 76, ran at full HD too, with between 30-40fps, averaging 37fps at the low setting. Aside from choosing the low preset, I also turned AA off, as well as any settings that had defaulted to low, to off as well. The game will run at closer to 40fps in more open areas, with settlements and built-up zones hammering performance. Still, the game ran smoothly enough. Battlefield 1 also runs at 1080p with the low preset and still looks good if I'm honest. I kept the resolution scale at 100% here and played through the opening couple of levels. Remember that we are working with just 1GB of RAM on this occasion as well, and from everything I've seen so far, the 740 isn't too much different in performance than, say, an older generation GTS 450. Finally, in Overwatch, here at 1080p with low once again, I saw 54fps on average with 100% render scaling, meaning we were running at full HD with no graphical compromises. To me, the game feels very playable, even with this 1GB video card. Forgotten and often overlooked as it may be, the 740 can still game, so whether you have this card, have found one cheap online, or plan on getting one for a secondary system, I hope this video helps you out. Guys, I'm sorry for the slightly shorter video today, but by the time you see this, I'll be away for the week. So this is one of a couple of videos going up in my absence. As always though, I hope you've enjoyed this little look at the GT740, a card that really isn't talked about that much anymore when compared to, say, the GT730 or GTX750. So as always, let me know if you have this card down below, how it performs in your system. Leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Leave a dislike if you didn't. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and hopefully, I'll see all of you in the next one.